Welcome children, take out your English literature book Roots, chapter 3, The Great Smoke of 1952. Let me first tell you the story in gist. The Great Smoke of 1952 written by Christopher Lane. Through this chapter, the author describes about the Great Smoke of 1952 caused by air pollution. The Great Smoke began on December 5, 1952. It was a cold wintry morning with clear sky dawned over London City. Londoners awoke with their usual daily routine. As the day progressed, a thick cloud began to develop around all the important city's landmarks. Within a few hours, the fog turned into yellowish-brown pollution released from the chimneys and vehicles. Ignoring the foliar, the Londoners went on during their usual work. London fog becomes London smog. When fog combines with smoke, it produces smoke. It was nothing new in London, but this smog was extreme poisoner that city had ever experienced. Due to high pressure, a layer of warm air high above the surface trapped the stagnant cold air at ground level. The temperature condition in London city was getting worse every day. The big smog settles in. The smog was so dense that nothing was visible. Till 5 days, the smog affected the transportation except the London metro system. Waterways, airways and railways got cancelled due to invisibility. Even during the noon, the drivers turned on their headlights to pass through the thick gloom. Londoners faced difficulties to carry out their job. By the time they returned home, their faces and nostrils blackened by the air and resembled like coal miners. Children were kept home to keep them away from the blinding smog. Criminals easily vanished into the darkness after committing crime. The smog even entered the building. The movie theaters closed as the ticket holders found it difficult to see the screen through the yellow haze. Health effects of the great smog. Londoners suffered from respiratory problems. Death rate increased. According to the official, 4,000 died prematurely in the immediate aftermath of the smog. Presently, many experts estimated that at least the great smog claimed 8,000 to 12,000 lives. The entire nature was affected by the great smog. After passing 5 days, that was on 9th of December, the west wind blew away the toxic cloud from the London city to the North Sea. Aftermath of the big smog. Initially, the British government acted too slow during the great smog, as it was common in London. After investigation, the Parliament passed the Clean Air Act in 1956. Which restricted burning of coal in urban areas. Smog-free zones were set up. Use of gas, oil and electricity became the primary concern. And with this, I am ending my today's class.